And my presentation is about an approach in depth of the systematic review of literature in the area of library and informational science. Carry out a review of the literature has been traditionally a way to demonstrate knowledge about a particular field of study, including vocabulary, theories, key variables, and phenomena, methods, and history. Conducting a literature review, it will also report about researches a research group influential in a particular area. Systematic reviews are scientific research that the unit of analysis in the primary original studies from which it is intended to answer a research question clearly formulated to a systematic and explicit process. Medical librarians have adopted and implemented very quickly this methodology. Later, it has spread to other non-medical areas such as scholarly, support engineering, or in the area of this education programs, etc. Then, the systematic review must meet at least three conditions. The first, use of academic databases as a primary source. Second, indicate the inclusion criteria and, if applicable, exclusion criteria to select the works to be part of the corpus of analysis. Provide data to replicate the study review. This is very important, the question of the replicate the review. In most cases, the lack of systematic reviews in this area of library science and information science is due to the limited amount of methodological details and lack of rigorous processes, explicit and obligatory review. This is a visualization that explains the process, the extracting data and combined data. I will explain this process. The method or protocol that it needs the first step is defining the question and defining also the types of question. It's important specify clearly the question that the review aims to answer. Systematic reviews often aim to find answers to individual questions or test a single hypothesis. Sometimes the field can be explained and it is necessary to identify the question or key question that must be answered. The question can be translated to PICO format. This is a format that the question divided with these indicators: population, intervention, comparison, and outcomes. This is an example of the Picot format with three questions, to retrieve literature about the scientific scientific gray literature about this is a doctoral thesis. The second step in this protocol is the establishing inclusion and exclusion criteria. The inclusion criteria can be studies of the topics proposed in the research question that indicate the state of the question, the results and the conclusion. Also, can be knowledge areas as science information and documentation, libraries, information and communication. The types of studies that it requires to locate to answer the questions, for example, articles, books and chapters, thesis and dissertation, conferences and conference reviews and bibliographies. The language of the works and the time limits more appropriate of the topic of the study. And for the exclusion criteria, for example, contents and deviate from the topics of the posed questions. About the terminology and formulation of the research strategy, an effective equation of search will be formed by descriptors and their respective qualifiers and descriptors and keywords, combined together by the most appropriate Boolean operators. The use of the descriptors is an option to locate the work related to a topic of interest to facilitate the recovery and to give visibility to scientific articles. The descriptors also are not only useful to perform a literature search, but also they serve to analyze the work areas of knowledge. This is an example of an equation search composed by keywords and operator and Boolean operators. And this equation must be reproducible in the some databases. The three step in this process is carrying out the search of literature, search strategy for identification of literature. In this search, it must be in the electronic database, for example, the Web of Science, Library and Information Science, Scopus, DOAJ, MEI, BASE, TBLA, etc. And the type of information, to search, for example, published journal papers, other published and unpublished reports of study, great literature, book chapters, and by hand, primary studies. The fourth step is the reviewing the process and evaluating the studies. After search of the relevant literature, it must it must evaluate the result. It is as we say to make office selection through the titles and abstract retrieval. To manage the results obtained in the various user databases, it is useful for the reference managers like a Node, Mendeley, etc. The search process and the selection must be detailed by a flow diagram that specifies clearly all stages of the process. And this is an example of the flow chart suite in the process. The next step in the protocol is extracting data. Systematic reviews adopt a formal and systematic approach to extract relevant information from primary studies, which often involves the development of a data extraction for that the reviewer will complete it for each of the studies in the review. And the last step is the synthesizing, analyzing and presenting data. Data synthesis involves collecting and summarizing the results of the primary studies. The included studies can be integrated quantitatively using statistical methods, and this is the meta-analysis, and qualitatively, systematically describing and integrating the results. And as conclusion, although in our field research the systematic review is still a relative unknown method, and we don't found the bibliographic corpus resulting from a systematic review of the literature. We believe that useful in assessing research needs and can be the starting point for further research. An important element in the systematic review process should be the detailed documentation of the processes such as selection of articles and documents located in order to make it reproducible. Systematic reviews provide methodological quality of the research, which are of deep interest in the research work of doctoral programs, and particularly in those with a clear interdisciplinary approach, as in the case of the research work of Education and Knowledge Society doctoral program of the University of Salamanca. And last, I put the reference utilizadas in this presentation.